Slurp.
Been a while since you were through here. All right, take a look. Okay, let's see. After a little tchotchke, are we?
Thanks for your assistance.
Business being here. You better turn heel right now, you hear me?
I'm gonna enjoy robbing you, tough guy. Hand it over.
I'll put a hole in your head.
Calm down.
Yeah, you're funny, like all a hole right in the head. You're the
Pearson.
Hello. That's what I like to hear.
I have better days.
Well, that's more honest than I was expecting.
Hi, Arthur.
Thank you.
Are you busy, Arthur?
Why?
Well, I know you think I'm just some effete buffoon.
What?
A man of words and not of action. Hardly a man at all.
Well, I think you're as slippery as an eel in an oil slick, but still a man.
Because I think I've found something interesting.
Yeah?
Have you ever robbed a stagecoach?
No, never. Well, who would have even thought? Of course I robbed a goddamn stagecoach. You know I have.
And what's the problem with stagecoaches?
The armed man attempting to put a bullet in your head?
Not quite. The odds. I mean, is it worth the robbing?
Sometimes.
I know. But, well, if you'd like to come with me, I can introduce you to a new best friend, and he's going to give you all the decent, robbable stagecoaches a hot-blooded degenerate could require.
Well, I could require a whole lot. Where do we find this friend of yours?
Rhodes.
Because what can possibly go wrong there?
Well, lead the way and we'll find out.
You sure seem to have got about around here.
You know me. I like to make friends in low places.
How the hell you end up down here anyway?
I could ask the same of you. I have a few commitments over this way. Some expenses to meet.
Expenses? What expenses? Gentlemen's canes and rabbits to pull out of hats?
Among other things, I had quite a nice little business going for a while. Shares in a gold mining company. Excellent returns for the investor of a certain financial standing. Until, well, that unfortunate run-in with the law.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Thanks for disappearing on us during that Sean business, by the way.
I'd done my part. Each to their strengths, dear boy. You know, you boys should really watch yourselves with those two families. This is a small town. People talk. I tried to mention it to Osea, but you know how he is. Anyway, while they're off chasing their pot of Confederate gold hidden at the end of some rainbow, let me present you with something real.
So, where exactly are we going?
The train station. The clerk there, Alden, is quite a fellow. Very informed on the comings and goings of coaches around these parts.
Ah, I see.
Here we are. We can hitch up outside. I'll make the introductions, Arthur. Come on. Hang back a bit and let me do the talking. We don't want to scare him off.
Hello, Josiah. How have you been?
Dandy. And you, friend?
Like I said, times are tough. My missus is a bad woman. Terrible woman.
They often are. But how's work, Alden?
Terrible. Wages got cut again. They reckon they just invented a new horse's carriage will be the end of us.
They've been saying that nonsense since they invented the wheel. The wickedness of bosses.
I know. My comrades here and I are greatly discouraged from the adequate fulfillment of our duty.
A discouraged man is no man at all, Alden. No man at all. My friend Arthur here has a present for you.
Here.
Ain't you kind, sir?
Call him Arthur. He's one of us, a fellow man of distinction.
Okay. Well, this is perfect timing. I think you'll like this one, Josiah. It'll be coming south down the river road through Siltwater Strand.
Thank you, Alden. Thank you very much.
Oh, and Josiah, if you or Arthur are ever out Strawberry Way, ask for my colleague there, a feller called Hector. He's also one of the, what did you call us again?
Discouraged men, Alden.
That's it, discouraged men. I like that.
Well, goodbye, Alden, or should I say, adieu.
Oh, adieu, Josiah.
What the hell was that?
I thought you might like to see that pantomime.
Gonna go rob a stagecoach.
River Road through Siltwater Strand, he says.
Okay. I think I know a good spot to wait. Follow me. What did I tell you? Simple as can be. Seems a lot of the station workers are in on it these days. Earning a pittance, the unions are whipping them up, so they want something on the side. Like he said, there, Strawberry. Could create a lot of opportunities for a man in your line of work.
I ain't sure about going back to Strawberry after all that market business.
Didn't sound like you left anyone alive to recognize you, so I wouldn't worry too much, dear boy. All this trouble. You gentlemen are becoming quite the celebrities, aren't you? Soon you'll be on the front of a dime novel.
Yes.
And dead, of course.
We're hoping to be long gone before that. Dutch has a plan.
If anything goes wrong, let's meet back here at this crossroad, okay?
All right.
Here we are. This is the spot. Okay. This should do.
Sure. Here.
I'm hoping we won't need those.
Better safe than sorry. So what were you thinking?
Well, according to this, the loot is located in a strong box, which is in the back. I'll put on a little performance, and you can scurry around, open the strongbox, and relieve them of their goodies.
And how do I open the strongbox without threatening someone to open it for me?
This should work.
And I can do this silently?
Well, I'm hoping complete silence won't be necessary. But you're going to wish you had your earplugs. This is Damson. Oh, very good, Alden, very good. Of course, if anything goes wrong, you can wave your guns around like you normally do. Hold tight. They'll be here soon. There it is. Right on time. Let's go. Keep your distance so they don't see you. And please leave that gun in its holster for once. Get the coach to stop. You hang back. Don't let them spot you, or you'll scupper the whole thing.
No, 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 no.
Good day. Oh. I hope you don't mind my singing.
Not at all.
I'm very.
It's a free country.
Did you say a show?
It's a small benefit. From opera. To Blackwater. Just
Mrs. Chester Danson. Stop the coach, my good man. Stop the coach.
Easy.
Whoa. I'm looking for a Mr. Soprano.
I don't know.
Miss Damson, you owe it to West Elizabeth.
Your card. The event is on the 23rd of this month. I can't say enough about Mrs. Damson. Magnifico. So sorry, gentlemen, for the interruption. Farewell.
Okay, girl.
Well done, sir. Well done.
It was easy. You did all the work.
Teamwork, my dear boy. Teamwork.
Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, it's only good. Go see Alden from time to time. See you soon, Arthur.
Ooh. Got any more opera singers for me to rob?
How are you, Arthur?
Ha! Easy.
Yeah. Follow me, boy. Good girl. You're all right, boy.
You got it?
I got it. I'll set it up. Here you go, pal. Let's get you cleaned up. There, boy. What are you doing?
Prepping for a robbery. I've had a good run of luck recently.
Okay.
Robbed a house up in Roanoke Ridge. Robbed a couple of drunken soldiers out near the swamps.
And what are you about to do?
A stage.
Well, good luck.
Well, you want to come with me? Now, I was going to ask Sean, but he's too much of a hothead.
What's the opportunity?
A bank stage, and without much security. This feller was telling me about it a couple of nights ago when we was drinking. It's gonna be coming right through, and the bank reckons the cost of security ain't worth the risk. Now, there'll be a couple guys, but nothing too serious, and lots of money. Easy money.
Well, that's always the dream of every thief. Easy money.
Well, like I was saying, my luck is in now, Arthur.
Well, then, why not? Who you taking?
I think we need a girl. See, I got a plan in mind.
Well, in that case, Tilly, you free? We got some work.
Sure. What kind of work?
Stagecoach.
Sounds good. Let's do it.
All right, come on. Let's mount up. Okay, follow me. There's a good spot where we should be able to cut it off northwest of Dewberry Creek.
And you're certain this information's sound, Bill? After that mess with the Cornwall stage, I want to make sure we're not riding into another army of guards.
Yes, I'm certain.
So what's the plan?
I was thinking a little womanly distraction.
I figured that much. But what's the story? Route, number of guards, you know, important details?
Just do exactly what I say and you'll be fine, all right?
How about we do exactly what Tilly says? I'd feel a lot safer.
Because I've done all the groundwork on this. Next time she brings in a lead of her own, we'll all bow down, I promise.
I'll remember you said that.
You follow orders, you stay alive. That's what they used to tell me in the army.
That kicked you out of the army.
They did not.
I beg to differ, Marion.
Have you been going through my things?
You shouldn't have left it out.
Can you believe this, Morgan? I don't trust her any more than I trust that Kieran boy. I never have. Running with them Foreman boys all them years. She could turn on us any minute.
Just shut your mouth or I'll shut it for you. You have no damn clue.
All right, just take it easy, you two. Get your minds on what matters so we do this right.
Let's cut up through the creek.
Great, that was beautiful.
This was the spot we first picked out for camp.
A dry riverbed?
Yep.
Who the hell suggested that?
Micah, I believe.
Well, that don't surprise me.
That's fine.
So the stage should be coming from over there.
What do you want me to do?
Just act dumb and silly and get the thing stopped. You know, like you do.
And what you mean by that?
Oh, come on, don't get all precious and stuck up on me now.
I don't like your manners, Mr. Williamson. In fact, I think you're an obnoxious idiot.
What'd you say to me?
I didn't say enough to you, you useless half man.
Half man? Half man, what does that even mean?
You two stop arguing.
He started it.
Here's a goddamn stagecoach. You doing this?
Yes. Come on, both of you, follow me.
What's the plan?
There's been a change of plan.
Yes, you act dumb and get them to stop.
Easy there.
Yes. Wait, Marvin the Martian?
Right. Let's split up, get the hell out of here.
Just because of how much they would have to pay him for it.
I know. Go on.
I'll see you back at camp.
Let's go, girl. Yep.
Now, come on.
Twisted my ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Who's there?
PlayStation Laura doesn't have a PlayStation Live account on it. So, like, she has to use my stuff.